Now this video, a lot of people might think is fairly tasteless, which is why I made it. And the effect is, it's the noise you'd get if you put a cat in a microwave. But I really don't suggest you ever put a cat in a microwave. I suggest you make a sound effect like this. So what I've got here is the various different sounds that I need. I've got cat noises, and I've got microwave noises, and I've got a special little noise here I made. And I'll play them individually. I'll use the solo button just so I can play the different noises. And the first noise is a purring cat. Now I'm using a purring cat to sort of symbolize a happy cat. When you make sound effect backgrounds, you have to sort of bear in mind you're going to exaggerate noises so that people can picture what's going on. So the first noise I've got is the caring, friendly cat. The second noise I've got is some little cat mews. And the third track here, this is again, this is the cat, but I will be altering the sound, because what you've got to imagine is when you close the door, the noise of the cat is going to be slightly subdued. So this sound I will be altering. At the moment I've just put it down at a lower level, but I'll be showing you how to give the illusion of sound behind a door. This one here, this track here, is just the various microwave sounds, the door opening, again exaggerated. When I recorded that microwave, I opened the door very slowly so it creaked, and I was quite positive about the sounds. And this little sound here, this little sound just here, I created by flapping my hand inside the empty microwave, because I'm assuming that if you did microwave a cat, it's not going to sit still. So this sound here is the flapping cat. And I made that by literally putting a mic near the microwave, put my hand inside, and I just beat it about. So when we combine all the sounds together, and I haven't finished mixing this yet, you'll hear how it's beginning to sound. So there we are, that's how it's sounding at the moment. What I want to do is this sound here, which is the cat inside the microwave, I want to muffle it down to give the illusion it's behind a door. So I'll play it to you how it sounds at the moment. So that all sounds quite clear. So I'm going to go to the track effects, and I'm going to go to EQ, which is something I've used quite a lot, and I'm going to take all the high frequencies down. Because if you imagine, when you close a door, the first thing you lose is the high frequencies. So let's see how that sounds. Sounding better, sounding more muffled. So I'll hear it now in connection with the rest of the track. So I'll hear that sounding, that's sounding okay. I think I've got the microwave here. This is the microwave sound running on a bit too long. So like all sound effects, you can just shorten. I can shorten this now and just drag it in. And if you just overlap it fractionally, that should give quite a smooth a smooth join between the two, so I'll just have a listen. Still can hear that a bit. There we go. And then the closing, this is the opening of the door. I'll just shift that up there, see how that sounds. Okay, so here we go, play it again. Once you've got everything in its rough order, the next trick is to go back and adjust the volumes or adjust the EQ so everything sits together. This is the noise of the cat flapping about. I might just bring that down just a fraction. You can see there's a little blue line here. That's the volume line. I could either go over to the volume side and move it down, or on Sony Vegas, you get a little line which starts off at the top, and the more you lower it, it effectively lowers the volume down. So you can see here on the cat inside the microwave, I've lowered the volume down because it's behind a door, as well as EQing it. On here, just to even out the cat sounds, that the sound of that one, the volume was okay, but on this one it was a wee bit loud, so I just dropped the volume down a tiny bit. So on this I've now dropped the volume of the cat flapping about. Let's see how that's sounding. That will do. So the real exercise I wanted to teach you in this one is when a door closes, you lose high frequencies. So that is all I've done on this one. I've taken the high frequencies. Anything after about 1K, you start to roll off. And you can use that if you're pretending there's music behind a door, or if you're listening to an argument on the other side of a wall, you would take the sound and you would drop the high frequencies. So I'm just going to see how that sounds, and I'll play you the final mix.